Live from the queue, there are 17 declared presidential candidates right now and only room for 10 of them in the primetime debate tonight. The other seven will debate here at the queue at 5 o'clock. Bill Hemmer and Martha MacCallum will host the debate, and they're here with me now here on Fox 8. Thank you guys for being here.
See you, Christy.
Good morning, Christy.
It's nice to
be here.
Yeah, it's nice to see you guys up and early for us. This is huge though for Fox News. Tell us how excited you guys are.
Well, we've been working on it for a while.
We think we're
ready to go. I don't think it's going to be easy, but I don't think running for president should be.
So, yeah, we've been working on our questions for the last couple of months, kind of honing them and fine tuning them. And with each passing day and new story that happens, we're kind of adding a little bit to the mix. But we do really want to make sure that we're holding people's feet to the fire. It's a big job. Right. It's the most important job perhaps in the world, the presidency of the United States. And so we want people to walk away from this debate feeling like they know these people a little bit better and they know where they stand and they know what kind of scrutiny they could be held up to.
Right. You guys are hosting the 5 p.m. debate. Mm-hmm. Now, these are with the 7 candidates who did not make the cut for the primetime debate tonight, starting at 8:50 on Fox News. But I think that this is just as big of a deal for them. 16 months, when we pick who the president of the United States will be, 16 months is a long time in politics.
Well, one of them's in the building tonight.
Right.
One of the 17 will be the nominees
right.
back here a year from now when the convention comes back. We set up rules a long time ago to try and figure out how you winnow this field, because there's never been this many before. And historically, there's never been 10 on the stage at one time, so that's what we declared for the 9 o'clock hour. And then we wanted to make sure that we were all inclusive for the remaining who were polled on these national polls, and that's how we came up with it. There is a real opportunity in this 5 o'clock debate
right.
for one of them to break out.
Right.
You know, keep in mind, too, that in the kind of world we live in, there are going to be sound bites that will be lifted from the 5 o'clock. If there are moments in that where people really stand out, they can really make a name for themselves tonight. And I have sort of a gut feeling that we may see one of these people from the 5 o'clock debate really move up into this process. So I think it's going to be a great evening in terms of, you know, starting at 5 and going all the way to 11. Mm-hmm. It's kind of like a big Super Bowl night.
Right,
we've got
right.
the 5 o'clock show, and then we've got the all right. of the sort of preparation for the 9 o'clock in between. It's going to be a really fun night in politics, and I suggest people tune in at 5 o'clock to get the ball rolling. It's going to be fun.
Now,
we were calling it the Sweet 16 until another one jumped in, so right. we can't use that
there
anymore.
Are, yeah. There goes our line, right? So let's talk about the primetime debate tonight. What are you guys looking for? What do you think that we'll see? Trump, I know it's been across the headlines on every network. What is he going to do? How
you know,
is he going to change the strategy
someone
tonight?
Described him as being a blunt instrument, and that's how he has come to make his mark.
Right.
And if he is that, he will rise to the expectation a lot of people believe that he has in him. If he doesn't, how we feel about this on Friday morning? I've told everybody all week, you know, just hold your fire on this position. And let's see when the smoke clears by tomorrow morning.
You know, and you have to watch number two. You have to watch Jeb Bush, who people are really waiting to sort of break out and make a statement mm-hmm. and have his presence be known in this race in a bigger way to a national audience. So let's watch Jeb Bush tonight very closely as well. We'll see how he does.
All right, and Bill, before we let you go, I hear you have a sister in town?
Yes, I do, North Olmsted. Hey, Tracy.
Hi.
Hey, Don.
Hi, Tracy. Have you had a chance to hang out?
What's that?
Have you had a chance to hang out?
No.
Probably not. Maybe
no.
after?
We came in yesterday afternoon, and we worked till midnight last night. So
I bet.
But it's a big, important day, and thanks for having us
of
on.
Of course. Thank you so
thanks,
much.
Christy.
And I've always wanted to say, hello, Cleveland.
Well, there you go.
And now you've said it. Yeah,
because we say it, that's like a running joke with us whenever we're on a remote or we dial into a conference call.
Well,
we
always
say.
It's great to be here. It's such a nice city.
Cleveland.
It's my first time, and I'm really enjoying it. Yeah, it's a terrific place. So
good.
Thank you so much for hosting. Thanks for having us, Cleveland.
They are super nice. You never know, right?
Who
you guys
knew?
Are awesome. Who knew you guys were so nice? No, I'm kidding. Bill Hemmer and Martha MacCallum, thank you so much.
Thanks,
good luck
Christy.
Tonight.
Thanks so much.
All right, we're